fall down as your legs are falling too. So don't have it already. Three beckons. There you go, there you go. Sorry, bad feet, Bessie. I understand. Do it again. Baseball, baseball, baseball. Crush. Yes. Okay, do both of these off of the bounce and back up a couple steps. Let me just see how we're doing. Back up a couple steps. Both of these off of the bounce. I'll get out of the way here. Just aim for the off of the bounce. Can you hang on to the record? There you go, there you go. Don't freeze your feet. It's fine, and then just don't be on top of the ball. Find the bottom of it. You can still hit it hard. Sorry, I was late. You're supposed to hit it again. Still hit the ball hard. Just find the bottom of it. You're on the back of the ball, swinging into it a little. I want you to be on the bottom of the ball, swinging up, okay? Yeah, like that. Think of a big circle, okay? Here we go. Bottom of the ball. Yeah, and then just hit it really hard. The spin will take effect. Yeah. In the air, and then we're done. Cream ball. There you go. Yes. Yes. Both sides. That's too much into it. Think, put racket underneath it and put your legs low. Do it again, do it again. Just turn the racket, legs low. Okay? Wait. That is a bad ball. Do it again.
Yeah.
You're pushing it. Turn. Two things.
You're snapping your body out at the same time. You're swinging the racket head. Pulling the ball up top of the ball. Okay? Your hand up. This is the racket head. Pull it up and over. What we want instead is that you're pulling the racket head up and across. So this way. Not this way, okay?
So now I'm telling you to get underneath the ball.
But don't come up at it like this. Even though the head tops, you said the racket's still to the side.
Yeah.
Make sure you turn so it's like your palm point away from you, and then you're turning it as you hit. Yeah, so your palm, your right palm. Do your backhand again. Do your backhand again. See how it's pointing that way right now? Mm-hmm. Should be. Do you set up, turn. Do your swing slowly so palms back up like three frames. No, frames. Like if you're, where
you're
looking
at yourself. Oh, yeah.
So there, right there. Pointing that way, right?
Mm-hmm.
Carry on. Now what I'm saying is don't let it keep pointing this way. Yeah. Actually turn it. You see your palms pointing over here now? Yeah. That's where your top spin's coming from, okay? Do just like that. Are you ready?
Okay.
There you go. Do it again. And now because you're hitting top spin, you can aim higher. Wait. Blast. Yes. Brush the ball. Brush. Ball spin? Sorry, I feel the need to say this. You obviously can hit through it, just really force yourself to be underneath the ball. Yeah, and then use your hands to get the racket up.
I'm sorry, I need to move. More cross court. Cross court. Your back hand, this way. Your forehand, over there. Wait, cross court. Alright, things move the ball.
In terms of, sorry, I'm blanking. 1 second, please. Oh, so split step, run through the ball, hit the ball, recover. We're actually really only looking at
sorry, 1 second. Easier if I show you.
Okay, so remember when you did your split step?
Yep.
The first step when you're about to go running. And then the whole time that you're running, that you're holding the racket. That's
yeah.
All we care about right now, okay? So you're holding the racket for as long as you can. What was the second thing? Oh, your stance. So now you're about to sleep, part three, let's say, that you're arriving the right way. So don't start like this. Go with your outside foot. Show me this. Don't let go early. Run it down while you're holding it. I'll do it right-handed so it doesn't look goofy. Anyway, so show me this. Hold it while you're moving. Then on two, you can let go. We're doing forehands and backhands. So you can let go, and then a big thing for the day that your legs are loaded and they're coming up when you're hitting, okay? So do it when you're hitting quick. So far so good, so far so good, and up. Perfect, perfect, and back, back, back. Alright, cool. I'm doing forehands and backhands, okay? Look like the person has moved from forward to backward. It would simply look like they turned, okay? From above. Above the other by pulling it this way. Okay, and then it goes straight to your neck.
Could you real quick?
So not like this, where the racket's protruding out to the side. Instead, this hand, get it up above the other. Okay. Yeah, pull it up, that'll help you. There you go, there you go. Down, up. Don't push up, you're being safe with your hands. Smash. Yes. Smash. There you go, there you go, that's the way. Yes. Make all of them a smash, like you just, they're angry with the ball or something. There you go. But spin it. Yes. Push because the ball was slow, but style of form. So
yeah.
Going into it, like extending out to the ball, instead just make it a circle and let it rip, okay? Alright, here we go. Circle, circle. Yes. Alright, now, I need to tune the air. And you just do the right shoulder again.
In the air. Do your backhand real quick. Take one big step forward. I know the net probably feels really close to you right now. Yeah, put your racket under the net and then feed it pretty high right here. So put your racket as low as you can reach. Yes, and as you're coming up, you'll hit it, okay? Yes, just like that. You're ready? Aim across. Can you take, can you come over here and do video? Yes. Can you
go back to your old back? Can you take that hand?
Yeah, go back a couple steps. Back a couple steps. Do old back hand as best as you can. Hold back. So flat. There you go, there you go. One more. Okay, jump. Can you make sure you can do? Maybe half a step back. Yes. Yes. All these are top spin. So success. Yes. You can hit the ball as hard as you want. That one would be nice. Just generally speaking. Well, so in tennis, you have to. One of the big themes of the sport is buying time and stealing time. So buying time, do you know what buying time and stealing time is?
Yeah. Buying time and burning time. Stealing time.
You're like rushing your opponent,
yeah.
Right? Okay. So if you're buying time and you do not play with spin, what will end up happening? Oh, so two passes can come through. I'll know if it's coming towards you. Anyway, if you're trying to buy time and spin a little top hand above the other hand, buying time, you know, quick for sure. There you go, that's the way. Try not to drift. If you're gonna move, I know I said you could move, but move before you hit, okay?
Yeah.
Alright, here we go. Don't push. Drip it. Yeah, even if I give you a bad feet. There you go. Yes. Two more. Up. Yes. Spin the ball. Spin faster. Come up fast. You got this, last one. Put this together, thank you. And finish fast. Thank you. Do it off the bounce first. Both hands on the ground. Okay, let's go. Go across the court. Quite a few getting used to it. Okay. You don't need to push it. The spin will make it sink, okay? The last one was fine, but you just swung a little slow. So go ahead and just swing like you don't care. Yes, like that. That top spin is so wonderful. Perfect. It might not seem like you changed anything, because you're technically pushing through your old backhand, which is how it had no spin. You're taking it at the same height of the ball, going through it like this,
yeah.
And then now. Remember how we were talking about pulling the racket head up and across? Now when you're hitting it, it's rolling off your racket, which is what we'd want.
Anyway, carry on. We do 3 minutes of this, 3 minutes in the air, then we'll go back to the baseline and put it together, okay?
Think up, swing up, straight to your neck, yes. Up to your neck. No, that's a push. Up. Yeah. This hit the bottom of the frame, so it went up, aim for the top of your racket. Yes, and do it fast. Oof. Yes, that was a good one.
same swing that covers all three. So that's why you swing up on it, a big part of it at least. So coming in square for this ball, square for that ball. This whole region, if you would, you're hitting. And your backhand, you hit through it a little bit. If I can get you to do the same thing, so waist, and then contact, rounded, going up to your shoulder, okay? So, sorry, this conversation started with me asking you if you can see spin back to be vertical. Sorry, when you bend your, because the knees will slide out, so if you slightly tilt it, you can come up when you're hitting. Sorry. Yeah, there you go. And just swivel your back foot. Now look, when I first was feeding you, can you see spins?
On the mat.
Okay, so when I was first feeding you, your forehand does have some top spin, but we just spent a few minutes trying to get it to turn. Well, look, instead of having... Okay, look. This zone, this whole area right here, you can have the same swing where your racket just goes up, okay? And anywhere in that zone, you can touch the ball. What I don't want is having different swings for all these different heights, that's it. Here, just quick. Yes. These are all very good. Catch the racket. Yes. Sorry if I'm giving you bad beats. Just keep swiveling your foot around. Chest. If your arm's moving, move it with your chest. Here, you look at me. This swing, see how my chest is staying back?
Yeah.
Or this one?
Which arm are you?
I don't know that the second one was great. Thank you. I don't know the second one was a great visual, but the point I think you get, right? Yeah, move your chest if you're moving your arm. Tutu, how you doing? Okay, here you go. There you go, I saw your chest turn. There you go, there you go. You might miss it a few, but you'll still hear me say yes. This is because I'm watching what your actions are. So you can hit a really good shot, but if you finish like this, you see how my back foot is like that? Just look, even if you miss it this ball, but you turned your chest, I'd be happy, okay? Here, here you go. Keep going. Legs, legs, and turn your body. Just make your sit down and come up violently. Right, look, you look like you're... That was such a bad visual. It's not meant to be. Your hip turn is what sends everything into motion, right? So it's not your arm leading and then your hip following. It's the other way around. It's your hip leads and then the I'll give you back in here. So it's not the arm goes first, which pulls the hip. It's hip snaps. The racket goes flying out because of what the hip did. So make that part kind of like a poppy, not slow, okay? Yeah. Fire with it. Don't guide it. Here you go. And fire. Yes. Sorry. You can start with the racket up if you want. There you go. And then draw up. Yeah, make it nasty. Absolutely crush the ball. Yes. Yes, that was a really good one.
Hit.
Oof, that was a really good contact. Keep going. Sorry if I jammed you. Ooh, another really good one. Turn yourself, turn. So those, the last two, I'm sure I fed too far from you. Don't beat yourself up about that, okay? You're just trying to get reps of turning your chest at the thing. Turn, yes. Turn. Ooh, that was a really
nice good one.
Yeah, you're getting it. Keep going. Gas. Yeah, make it nasty. The racket should feel light. You just have a good flow. Spinning everything. Yes. Oof. Another good one. That's helping us pick up balls a lot faster, actually. Because they're all grouped up right here now. Alright, here we go. A few more. It's okay. No. You were late because my ball went faster than you're expecting. No big deal. Next one. Yes. Yeah, don't hand it though. Use your whole body. There you go. Turn your body. Yes. Yeah, you're on the right track. Last one. Keep tracking it. And fire. Swivel your foot with your chest. Yeah, do it that way, okay? Does that make sense? Alright, let's start again.
weird because before you were closer to the same height of the ball, and then now we've separated. But don't be timid. Just guess at it, okay?
Hit up on it first, and then make a bend. Yeah, correct. You're looking to play at full speed?
Yes.
And the ball still goes in because of the spin.
Close.
Get it up first. So thin contact. Yeah, and then sit the crap out of it.
Yeah.
These are all sinking in now, right?
Move your foot.
Yes.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Okay. Swift. Your foot. Yes. That'll be good. Yes. That'll be too short. That's the right. Yes, 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 yes. You can hold the racket at the top of the front. You can do however you want. I'm focusing on just getting the racket as friendly to both. Think of where you're aiming. You're aiming cross court, right? But your stance is going this way.
Yeah.
So yeah, aim. There you go. It's a little too much. It's going over there now, right? Yeah, fine. There you go. Hit it straight. And straight into it. And it like sails on you. Drop the racket. And then come up the ball. Even if it's up high, you're swinging up and pulling the racket head up and across. Yeah? So it's this way, not this way. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. One thing. Do your swing real quick. Pause. When you're actually hitting the ball, you let this happen too much, which is why the ball goes crooked even though your stance is supposed to be going towards me. Notice how your wrist is like straight right now. Lay hand back. This is how your hand should be at contact, which makes the ball go straight. Okay? And racket would go up this way, not that way, okay?
Okay. Yeah, right now when you're showing me, see how you can see my racket stroke? Yeah, you're showing me this way, which is correct. Yeah, make the strings point to your stroke. What were we doing? Let's go forward a few steps. Okay. You can hit it cross court, but it's gonna go over my right shoulder, okay? You don't stay low the whole time. Just be like you move, and then when the ball's near you, just dip and then strike. Okay. Okay. Here you go. Dip. Up. Yes. Just like this. That was perfect. Just swivel your back leg for me. Okay. Here you go. Dip. Up. Yes. Oh, sorry for being annoying. Just one final comment. You need to catch the racket when you're done for me. Okay.
Yeah.
Remember I complained about you stopping your racket prematurely, so actually hit yourself with the edge of the racket softly and like the muscle. Yeah, actually let it rest on you, all the way to your shoulder, or catch it. I gotta break the habit of you stopping your racket, okay? Yes, either it comes to a stop in your own hand, or you go to your own shoulder. But yeah, don't stop in front of you anymore, okay? Here we go. Here we go. Down. Up. Yes. Down. Up. Catch it while it's moving. Yes, keep your swing circular. It's okay. I know I hit your leg. Keep going. Up. Yes. Swing up. Don't worry. Down. Up. Turn your foot. Do a practice. Here, put your racket on the floor. Tuck in.
Okay, when you're done, so at the beginning, elbow is like in, let's say, and then when you come up, just turn your elbow over. Practice two more. Turn your foot at the same time, so this whole thing swivels together. Yes, like that. Like you're hooking your whole body around on that. Yes. You got it? Now when you hit your forehand, show me the same image when you're done, that you're looking over your elbow, and your back foot is turned, okay? Yeah, see your back foot turned on that one? Do one where you leave your back foot quiet. Yeah, so your foot's pointing that way, but your chest is pointing towards me, right? So, this would be known as your height of the ball. You come from way underneath it, come up now, sliding up and across, okay? Yes, sliding up and straight to your shoulder, okay? Do not go this way when you hit, go this way. Pull the racket head up and across, okay? So look at me. I know I'm telling you to go up, but not like this.
Yeah.
This way. Go up and across. This way. Does that make sense? So as you're actually hitting it, you're going like this, not like this, okay? Pull the racket head up and across. Don't start with the racket dangling, it'll feel heavier. Have it vertical. There you go. Thank you.
starting slow at the beginning. This bit fast. Slow, fast. Wait longer, okay? Close now, full speed. Okay, don't start early and go like medium speed, wait longer so you will feel rushed, and then go top speed. Okay, here we go. Wait, too soon. Every legs are low and you're loaded, push off this way. How do you go to your forehand first of all? Yeah, so do that after your Swiss step. So land and then use this leg to push that way. On your very first step, so when you just did that, was your chest forwards or turned? Yeah, so turn on your first step. So go land, use this leg, push over there, and arrive sideways. Yeah, just that. Don't even worry about the rest. Just the first step. So look at me again. Just this, okay? Show me that. And turn while holding the rest. So yes. And then just to get back to what we did a second ago, do your second step also. So step one, you're doing your full turn. Step two is when you can let go of the racket. And then last ball, pause. So your feet aligned right now or take it? Yeah, so basically the rule of thumb is wherever your back foot goes, you just don't cross it with your front foot. So moving towards you. This would be flawed. Over here. Turn your foot every single time, down, and then up and unturn. Except just like this. So down first, and then up and unturn. Yeah. You'll run over. Let's do different for a second, okay? And then you go left foot, right foot, tuck in. And then as you up, pull your back foot, use the racket. Yeah, yeah, go back. Do this a couple times. So basically the point is one, two, then dig. So just go over there somewhere. One, two, sorry. Should be coming towards me based on how your feet are lined up. Now line it up over here instead. No, stay there. And then line it up towards me. I can see your rear foot. There you go, there you go. And the ball will go major possible. Yes.
Yeah.
Run, run, run. Do one, two, four, hit. One, one, two. And then up. Make sure you don't cross your feet. Up when you go. Go back. Side step on your way back. You see? You're going to be starting this. Let's step back. If you recall, I said you let go of the racket on two. Hold the racket the whole time you're running over. Okay? Just this. Turn. So, take a step. Exactly as you did to your chest. I'm pointing that way, but take a step. So, look at me.
The one you just showed me.
And in place. Land. Take a step. Take a step. Bring your left foot out. So, land first. Then step. Yeah, it's like this, okay? So, it's like a little jump over here. Go again. Just like this. And then run over there. One, two, towards me. So, one, two, sit down, and come up and finish your swing. That was exactly what we want, okay? Side step back. Side step, don't cross your feet. If you're gonna do the crossover step, do it when you're far. By the time you're in the middle, be side stepping, okay? Alex, don't let go. Turn your chest fully to the side. Yeah, do it again, do it again. So step, hold turn. Hold the racket, don't let go. Hold it, hold it, bring it down. One, two, bang, and then you're done. Don't let go of the racket until you do your second step. So don't arrive with your hands out.
Yeah.
Go all the way through the ball. One. Sorry. You say it first. One, two, and on two, my front foot's hitting the floor. And also off. So proper visual here. Move while holding it. One, two. Running over here. One, two. Okay? Don't run with the hands off. Okay, do it again.
One, two, blast. And you've pivoted your foot. Alright, I'm gonna start executing. Yep. Here.
You're on the right part of your foot, but look at where your heel's pointing. Do you see your heel's that way?
Yeah.
So if I'm aiming towards you, let's say this is not. Swivel it around towards facing your opponent, okay? Yes, correct. Now playing this ball up. Oh, by the way, so real quick, when you're doing this from now on, do it in two steps. So if I'm aiming this, I'm making contact with that ball, but I'm aiming it to you. In two steps, show me. Wind it up. Take two steps. So it'll be your back foot first, your left foot first, and then right foot. And let's say if you're going up here, pause for a second. So I'm facing you, let's say. I'm right-handed, so this is my back foot, you're left-handed, this is your back foot. This ball towards you, so boom, boom, and back. Two steps. So get in your stance in two steps. Wrong foot first. Turn. Sir. Look, your chest is facing the ball, right?
Mm-hmm.
So instead, turn your chest so your chest is to the side fence. There you go. When you're done is when your chest will face forwards. Yeah, at the beginning, though, you're going to be sideways, right? So at the beginning, your chest is facing your rear leg. And at the end, your chest is facing your front leg. Yeah. And then, yeah, your chest is facing your front leg. Mm-hmm. And you swivel with your back foot, that's what we want, okay? Anyway, so what I'm trying to say, though, is in two steps, get all of that down. So I'm aiming this ball to you, step one, step two, tucked in, and I've got the line that I want, and then swivel your back foot. Show me all that in two steps. No. Why no? You know why? Well, do it again. Do exactly what you just did. Is your chest turned yet?
No.
Yeah, so that's why. So look at me. So in two steps, boom, boom, and I'm turned, right? And if I'm going this way, I'm already turned on step one. Yeah, so turn on step one. Boom, boom, yeah, and then arrive. Sorry, I'll stand somewhere so you have like a spot. No, if you can't, is this lying towards me or is it a little off? Just a little, yeah. Do it again. Yeah, start again. And then bounce. Add some bounce to it. So if I'm aiming towards you, one, two, yeah. You know what, for a second, forget the perfect line and just try bouncing into it so it feels more natural. So if I'm aiming towards you, wait a second. I'm aiming towards you and it bounces. So boom, boom. And I'm talking. You do that to me. I'll show you one more. Turn. Your right foot, spin it around. And land in your stance. Yeah, like this. But don't worry about going forwards for now. Just think in place. There you go. You got it on me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do it again. Do like 10 of these. Yeah, perfect. Hold the record the whole time. Remember, there's like the first thing I said. Yeah. And this is aligned towards me, right? I'm over here now. Same thing. Boom. Now let's say I'm over here. Sorry, when I say do this ball, that also means sit down and then come up when you hit. Yeah? And then come up when you hit. Swivel by. Would anyone want to see right now? Look, first thing you'll figure out pretty quick, the stance deal. So is it aligned to you or off? Yeah, so first you'll get the stance right. And then once you get that, you need to learn how to snap yourself. Swing your foot. Swivel your foot around. Yeah, like this. Come up. Don't worry about pushing forwards. Just come straight up and swivel your foot around. Yeah? Turn your back heel so it flings. It flings out when you're hitting. Yeah, like this. Only comment though, it doesn't need to go pointing crooked. Just do it so it's both feet are straight, okay? Yeah, like this. Got it? Okay, this ball. Up and hit. Perfect. This ball. Yeah, so through your foot. Don't go all the way to your toe. Actually, stay on the ball of your foot. Put some weight on it. So like, I think lean back, have your back leg support more of your weight. How do I work this? Don't go all the way to your front foot, because then your back foot's barely touching the floor. Think of it like your chest stays in between your legs, so both legs are carrying half your weight, okay? So instead of... That's going over here. There's a line in between.
small gap running between your feet, that's where you're pointing. So this, even though it's close, is not aligned towards you. This is going over there, okay? So line the ball up. Chest, hips, and knee all switch over. Try to get it. Alright, pause for a second. I'm aligned towards you. Tucked in right now. And then what I want is when you come up, when you're about to come up, swivel just your back foot and actually stand on your foot. So come up and yeah, put weight on your back foot, like actually sit on it. Swivel it first and then put weight on the foot. All right, so let's do this real quick. One second. First, a couple of the things I need to do first are not going to seem that important, but if you can please focus on them, and then it's going to add things, okay? Yeah. All right. Actually, show me. How do you take your acrobat on your forehand? All right, so from now on, if you can, instead of going back with one hand by itself, hold the racket on the throat the whole time, and just turn your shoulders. Show me that. Don't let go of it. Yeah, just hang on to it. It's going to be a pain in the butt for a second. Second question. Okay, I can explain why, but for now, let's tell you what I want you to do. I was feeding different depths, I'm sure you noticed, so like some basic and then some shorter and deeper. Instead of arriving on anything you can get behind early, you should be able to go close stance on. You're going open stance on almost everything. So when you're going short ball in particular, don't arrive with your back foot. Your hips are going to be open. Go close stance. So yeah, one, two. Oh, here's just a caveat though. Do what you just did again. Pause. Do you see how I can see your rear foot? So this would be technically flawed in that your feet are crossed. So look at me real quick. Just look at me. So right now I'm lined up towards you.
Yeah.
And my feet are on the outside of each other, right? Like my
foot is under my hip, this foot over here. This is when feet are crossed. You see how you see right behind me? So don't go over the left foot over here, left foot on the outside of you. Go close stance. So show me real quick what you visualize close stance as. Okay, pause for a second. Your heels are on top of each other. See, there's like a straight line here.
Yeah.
So when you pivot your foot, it's gonna feel like you're on a tightrope. Mm-hmm. You want your feet wider. So now let me see your back foot. Your back foot so I can see it entirely. There you go. This is still close stance. Anyway, do your swing now.